with the comments from Pamela Liggett's, Karen Materna, and some of the other ones also lead up to this, but this is the part that I really need law enforcement to pay very close attention to.
And I'm so impressed I was using my regular voice today. I just couldn't speak ill of proper in the southern tone when I was being so melancholy and serious. But now you know what, Mr. Cropper? Mr. Cropper, tomorrow morning, I'm telling you right now, Mr. Cropper, you need to be back over at the police department and you need to be asking for your records again, Mr. Cropper, because Mr. Cropper, fuck you. You going to jail, son. Yes, you are. Oh, yes, son. Oh, you going to jail.
No.
You are.
Right.
You are. I mean, and you know what? They won't be serving you no fried chicken and government cheese in the pen. Mm. No, you're going to be lucky if you get black-eyed peas and some spinach.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, but you be calling. You get over there tomorrow. You get over there, Mr. Cropper. You get over, because you know what? Miss Pamela was back on the phone with Lane. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I'm going to be on the phone with them every day, darling. So you'll have to go to see what I have reported back to you. Mm-hmm. To see, now I'm starting to track a paper. Mm-hmm. Oh, Mr.
Cropper. Let me show you something. I want to show you something.
Okay.
I'll be back.
Listen to me, Mr. Cropper. Pay attention. I only told them what you said yourself. And you know what was really cute about you, Mr. Cropper? You didn't show in that report what the finding was, did you?
There's no finding.
Mr. Cropper, I don't know what to tell you.
It's 3 pages, no finding.
But you see, Mr. Cropper, I didn't say you had drugs and children hidden in your house. I didn't say that. I said...
Now, I've never made a claim that she had drugs and children hidden in my house or anything else. This wackadoodle is making things up now at this point. So here's what she called in and made the false claim of today.
Exactly what you said. Hmm. Remember right. that, Mr. Cropper? Has your imagination taken over
Moms
your brains? Mm-hmm. You know what, Mr. Cropper? You sounded rather high today, too.
She's nice.
That concerned me. That concerned me, Mr. Cropper. And your son was there, wasn't he, Mr. Cropper? Isn't that what you said? You made him a pork roast. Yeah, I was concerned.
So, I was earlier saying things. This right here, have her blocked. Have all of these people blocked, as a matter of fact. But this one here is now talking about when I was talking to some folks about making a pork loin for myself and my son. So, this tells you they're stalking again my stuff.
I heard about you. Mm-hmm. I was. You sounded rather high. Not me. I'm just eating popsicles. Pineapple upside down cake. Mm-hmm. A lot of fried chicken. Mm-hmm. I hope I have time to pack. You know, I have medical needs, Mr. Cropper. I do. With the Ohio PD there, you know, your little police department. How many police are on that department, Mr. Cropper? Because you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to try to talk to every police officer you have on your department. Sooner or later, every one of them will be writing a report about you, Mr. Cropper.
This woman here is the attorney. She knows my mom's been passed away for 10 years. This is what they're trying to do in order to try to trigger a response out of me, and I'm not going to give it to them. But this proves the lies, the false reports, the slander, the insanity, the malicious intent, and obviously more in admitting it, that she's going to continue to make false reports and call. So the harassment here is like she's telling you right point blank. She's been harassing and she's going to continue to do so. Today I made false claims that I was supposedly high. Right. I don't even do drugs. I don't even smoke cigarettes anymore. I haven't smoked cigarettes in 4 years.
because I was concerned today. But you sounded so high, you couldn't even pull yourself together. Uh-huh. You could not pull yourself together today. I was so concerned. I had to call them again. I got a new officer this time. I did. And he was righteously concerned. He said, oh, my Lord, this man has a child in his home that he doesn't even have custody or visitation of.
So she's saying that I don't have custody or visitation of my son who is in my home, which we all know is complete bullshit. So there's another part of the false report here and the fact that I was supposedly high. So she's been using, now I'm going to use the police department to tag, to target me. And it's also because running around with this Karen Materna, she's using this one as one of the mouthpieces as well. Just like when they called in and made the false police report before. I told you, they're nuts.
I said, yes, they're sitting down to a pork sirloin dinner. And this man is higher than me. Did you watch that live? Oh, yes, I have to agree because I'm wrong there. Okay, Mr. Cropper, there's tomorrow's news for you, darling. We don't want you to be without anything. See, this morning, Mr. Cropper, I was feeling real sorry for you. Not so much. So I'm going to tell you what. I will tell you what, Mr. Cropper. I will call any time I have a concern or a tip for the police about someone's behavior. Mm-hmm. You just happen to be the lucky one because you said you knew a pedophile that was on there. Oh, gasp, imagine how concerned I was. Mm-hmm. Goes for you too, Turners. I don't think you're going to get by with calling me a pedophile. Mm-mm.
So Karen Materna calls me a pedophile online for months. This one makes excuses for it. They're not here running around. Karen Materna and this one, or Karen Materna's on making a video, which the police department has, where she was falsely claiming that I said I had child pornography on my equipment, which is false. This one here, Pam Liggitt and Karen Materna, are the ones who called the police department to also make the false report. And now, because I told people who were also being harassed, I showed them my report, which is public record. It's a public document. Anybody can get it. I showed them who called. I showed them what was said. And I suggested to all the people that these people have harassed, targeted, threatened, etc., go to their local police departments, etc., and get copies of any call logs or reports that these people may or may not have put against them. But you can see how insane these people are. And now this one, here's the attorney suddenly down here being very quiet, sitting in the comment section, running her mouth. And we have Pam Liggitt doing all this talking in this one this time.
No, I don't think you're going to get by with saying that and then saying it was a joke. I guess that's the way I have to handle these things, huh, Mr. Cropper?
She's nuts.
Well, you are a joke, darling. How much of a joke you are.
Nice to see my blue shit, though.
Our Pam is sassy.
I am sassy. I had a little napping. Mm-hmm. Hey, first 15 hours of scoping tonight. Now, Mr. Nitra. Oh, Miss Anitra, why do you always act so damn stupid? I mean, girl, you know, I thought stupid was just an act you put on, but I do declare you are just dumber than a rock. You seriously did not go on there today.
This lady claims to be some great Christian, by the way, too. These people, they're just... speaks for itself. It's ridiculous.
And speak ill of Mishana, did you? Oh, but you spoke so ill of me. You were like a little cheerleader there for Cropper. Did you give him a cyber blow job, dog? Did you?
That's Christian lady, huh? Oh,
did you? Because you know what? When he said that he turned Mishana down, I nearly fell out of my
chair. What?
He turned you down.
Yep.
Turned it down about what?
A relationship with him, and he turned you down, ma'am.
Really?
Yeah.
Now, does he have proof of this? Because I'd love to see the proof of this.
Well, I doubt that we need that. He was high.
Yeah. This one here, this Shauna, is somebody that myself and two other girls were very good friends with. And Shauna tried to manipulate a bunch of stuff and run her mouth and place lies and everything else for with this Pam and the Matern and the rest of them. So I told her I was done with her. I wasn't going to mess with the lies, and I was done with her her BS. And Anitra and Amy Lynn actually stopped being Shauna's friend when she tried to tell them basically if they were going to be my friend, they couldn't be hers. And they saw the manipulation stopped. And ever since then, this Shauna has shit-talked myself, Anitra, and Amy Lynn. Shauna even came out at one point with a multiple-hour video with this one here and somebody else about Amy Lynn, who's a victim of domestic violence. And they came on for 3 hours claiming it was false, running her name through the mud, just saying all kinds of nasty, vile things. They do this to all kinds of people. It's horrific. It sincerely is horrific that they do these things to people. But it shows you the mental state.
He was high, like the devil high.
Yeah. Why, is Anitra sharing her drugs? Because
I don't.
He's not taking his lithium, so.
Well, he was taking something today because he was higher than a kite. Higher than that young child. He was driving over to pick up that young child. I should have alerted him to that. Mm-hmm. I should have. Mm-hmm. Oh.
That is seriously fucking comical.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. 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 Oh.
Wow. I don't think I can finish eating my grapes. I'm a little...
You know what I'm eating? I'm eating a pineapple and cherry popsicle. Mm-hmm.
Anyway, that Shauna girl was like liking me, and I told her absolutely not. And she's scorned as crap because not only did I turn her down, and that's when she got like really pissed. And then her two other people who were supposedly her best friends saw through her BS and kicked her to the curb because we weren't going to deal with this kind of situation. And she's been like this ever since. She's joined up with this Pam Liggitt, Jennifer Flavin, Gina Nelms. I mean, all these different people, Karen Pettit Materna, et cetera. So she's been over here pissed because we all kicked her to the curb and wanted nothing to do with her after her crap. And this has been an ongoing thing ever since. She got mad because I told her no. She lives in Colorado. I don't do long-distance relationships anyways.
I wanted to make Anitra jealous because it's kind of red.
And that comes from this one and Shauna and the rest of them calling Anitra a red rocket, making false claims that she has sex with a dog. It's the mentality of these people. And that's also the one, the Materna for the videos for... statement of fact videos, the first one she did that she talks about me, something about lithium, whatever, and she talks about Anitra with the red rocket thing. That's what they're all referring to. This is what they do constantly.
Oh, yeah. You don't wake me up in the middle of the night, bitch. I hear this going on, you know.
Can we all look? Let's take a look at a walk down memory lane, shall we? I know I have somewhere.
You know, she doesn't realize it's an honor to be doxxed by us. So when that happens tomorrow, Anitra, don't you be crying. Mm-mm.
So now she's threatening to dox Anitra tomorrow. Isn't that interesting? Right. Yet they want to claim that supposedly they were doxxed by me repeatedly before everything else. They're nuts. And we really need to have law enforcement step in and do something because somebody's going to end up getting hurt.
No. We don't want no tears about.
First off, I found Justin and Cropper's outfits.
Oh, what is that? What is that?
You're going to have to ask Cropper and Justin because I don't know.
Exactly what I said earlier.
Oh, my Lord. They look like, I don't know. Could you zoom in the crotch here? What are they?
I said earlier, this is what they're going to do. They're going to come out and start clowning and everything else and trying to start shit. And this is exactly what they've done.
Yes.
What is that? Is the
oh, hold on, it just got all
like jumpsuits. Are those like leather? Wait, are those like leather jumpsuits? Oh my heavens. Put that away, young man. Don't. No time for that. Go on. I hope that, oop, is 33 still here? I did not. Oh, was he afraid? Did he laugh? Why did 33 leave? I wanted to speak with him too.
I gotta find.
And then Mr. Cropper.
I got rid of him.
Mr. Cropper, you cannot. For the life of me, son. Oh, no. Mr. Cropper. You cannot for the life of me.
This is Pam Liggitt. Just so we're clear.
Be trying to imitate my southern accent. You look such a fool.
This is how triggered they are. They're too fucking stupid to realize that you're doing that as a fucking joke to irritate them.
It doesn't irritate anybody. It proves that she's a mentally unstable. That's like she's doing now. Like, she's got multiple personalities, I believe, because she is definitely something very not right, as you can tell from listening to this conversation.
I know, and it only gets worse every day.
Karen, whose purse are you talking about?
Where was I the other day? I was somewhere the other day, and I told them, oh my God, I started talking like this. Oh, it's a bye-bye, and don't be saying that, though. You can say words like the C word. You can say the F word. You can say everything, but you cannot say Jesus Christ in my presence. Nor can you say
that or Sam. GD. That
you can't
or
say
GD.
Any of those things in my presence, young
no,
man.
I don't
now
like
you
it.
Be careful. I heard Miss Judy today. She said, Almighty.
Hey, Steven.
Judy said, Jesus Almighty. I'm like, Judy, you got to rein this in, darling. I don't care if you use those other words. You just call them whatever you like, but leave the Lord out of it. It ain't.
For the record, she doesn't sound anything like this at all, obviously.
For him. Cropper's over there thinking he's such a big boy. He's such a big boy because he can use that C word. He said something. He said something about us that we couldn't even be a C word. I'm like, hallelujah.
I'm still laughing about the fact that he said that he turned me down. This is amazing. I want to hear the rest of the story. Cropper, can you finish the story? I'm assuming you have proof of this, right, Cropper?
You begged him, girl. You begged him. You begged him. Don't you understand?
I know.
You on his top because you look like a something or other, he said. I was like, oh, Lord.
What'd he say? What'd you say?
I can't remember what he called you. I can. Oh, he
something
is a
he'll
child.
Never have? Yeah. It's understandable. I get it.
Yeah, it's too bad they don't make condoms in his size. As big as he is, then everybody would know he's a prick. Put that right over his head, all the way down his little shimmy body. And then we know what he is. I'm in rare form, I must say. I must tell you that 33 inspires me. We should have him on more often. He inspires me. He does. He's up the road, you know. He and I could meet at the Wild Horse. That's a nice little casino.
You know what I should do? Let's do a scope with Cropper, Justin.
Okay.
Rob. Matt and 33. Not to like rotate, but we gotta figure this shit out. Because this would be fucking amazing.
Oh, Judson would just lose his temper and run away.
Well, I mean, he's a bitch, just like his spooning partner, the bitch boy Cropper, so.
Yeah. Yeah. They must think that they're real slick.
I can't get into that. People actually believe. You got, please tell me people laughed at Cropper saying that, because that is fucking amazing.
Oh, what? Oh, no, they were all oohing and aahing. Oh, yes, I didn't know. I'm not surprised.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Oh, Jim, you're such a good man.
Because last I checked, it was him driving hours to stalk a woman.
Mm-hmm.
Not
mm-hmm.
me
yeah,
trying to
right.
have any sort of anything like that with him. God, that is fucking disgusting.
This one here was friends.
Dude, the man looks like he's got fucking pubic hair growing out of his fucking chin.
He's got that one eye that don't fall right.
And that's what makes me wonder, like, Anitra, when you go down on Cropper, do you take your teeth out or do you leave them in and just let his pubic hair from his chin that matches the downstairs? Do you just let that floss your teeth? Your fake teeth, that is.
Aren't they special? Mm-hmm. They are special kind of special. I think this is going to trigger somebody.
Wow. Dude, your ass got dropped by Billy Sessions.
You
yeah, I
don't know. Fuck on.
I don't think, yeah. Remember how she used to talk in the lobby?
Mm-hmm.
Remember how
she would stalk him and his girlfriends?
Oh, yeah. It still probably does. But
see, I have proof of that.
Get out.
However, you, Cropper, don't have proof of anything.
Mm-mm.
I mean, supposedly wanting you and you turning me down. This is amazing. This is fucking hilarious.
I know. I, like, laughed. I was like, oh, you wished, darling. You wished.
That's just gross.
I know it is. I think the one time I didn't say anything to him was...
Oh, Karen, did you get the last page?
Was when he was...
did you get the last page of the report? Because I know there was important information. I know there had to be more information.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to have to pull up our conversations because... Well, the last time that we talked and he'd upset Amy Lynn again. By the way, he was talking to me. And Amy Lynn blocked him, so I had to beg her to unblock him. And he was like, well, now that she has me blocked, I guess I'll just go into the country concert. I can't remember what concert it was by himself. And I'm like, oh, well, shit then. I'll come with you. I'm on my way. That was literally it. And then he cried and was like, well, I guess I can't. You can since Amy Lynn's not talking to me. So if you want to show how desperate you are, Cropper, please continue with your bullshit fucking lie.
Oh, you should put that chat out.
I know. I think so.
That would be interesting to watch him crying over Emma Lynn.
That would be.
Mm-hmm. The lies.
Yeah.
Yeah. All lies. All of them. The lie.
Where she said she was scared of him? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And he threw a temper tantrum every time she didn't call him back or read his messages and return it immediately. Or,
uh-huh.
Yeah. See, so... Cropper, darling, if you want to keep going,
uh-huh.
Let's keep going, little buddy.
Uh-huh.
Do you want to go there, bud? I don't think you do, Cropper.
Uh-huh.
I keep telling you to stop running your fucking mouth.
Yeah.
Go read through all of our conversations before you fucking start spewing bullshit. Because while you spew bullshit, Cropper, I'll be putting out everything.
Oh, is Lana still here?
Yes, she is.
Oh, Miss Lana, I'm so sorry. Mm-hmm.
Hey, Jen, Izzy's live.
Mm.
I think we should all go over there. Go have some
why
fun.
Not?
No.
Why not? No, I said, why not?
Oh, okay. Guys, let's all head over to Izzy's. We'll share it out. Pam might be a little traumatized by what goes on over there, though.
What?
I don't think you'll do well over there. You'll get pissed.
I will?
Because one of them is an atheist.
Oh, Lord, I can handle that. Oh, yeah.
But he's actually a really cool dude. Don't you think, Jen?
Yeah, I think he's a nice guy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Let's all head over there, y'all want?
I haven't had an atheist for lunch for a long time.
I can't with you tonight, Pam. Oh, my God. This is amazing. Mm-hmm. All right, guys, let's all head over there. We'll share it out.
Right.
Okay.
Cropper. Good night. Hold on, Cropper. Hey, Cropper. I'm going to need you to put out that proof of you turning me down.
Oh, yeah, Sam. And the Turners need to put out proof that Lana's an alcoholic.
Oh, for fuck's sakes.
Yes, we need to see that, too. I'm sorry, Miss Lana. I didn't want to bring that up.
Because she went into one of my scopes one night after she'd been drinking, and she said she'd been drinking.
Mm-hmm. On her birthday, wasn't it?
Yes, I believe it was her birthday.
Whatever. Mm-hmm. The fuck out of here. That's all you got, NJ? Mm-hmm. All you can say about Lana, so you go for that? Uh-huh. So that's all you guys go with. You called Pam a drunk.
What would you call them when they were riding around in their van all drunk and shit?
Well, yeah.
With their extension cord.
Well, mm-hmm.
Driving with an extension cord. That makes sense. Mm-hmm.
All right, guys. Let's all head over there.
Okay. All
right. Bye.
That was so that I can record the entire thing later, but I actually got all but like the first 10 minutes of it, which is no big deal. So I'm not even bothering with it, but now you see kind of what we've been dealing with, what I've been dealing with especially.